Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about those itchy mosquito bites, how to treat them, how to prevent them, and loads more. Well, I'm going to answer all of those and loads of other questions in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we always look at the evidence. Lakshmi, please do a video on mosquito bites. Lakshmi, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of Insect Bites, where you left this comment. It might be a bit late for you this video now, but I really hope these tips help you and anyone who's watching, because mosquito bites are actually, well, mosquitoes are actually one of the world's deadliest animals, who are responsible for millions of bites and deaths every single year. So let's get going. Okay, so let's begin with the science, because this is probably one of the most important bits. So mosquitoes, why do they love biting people? Well, for female mosquitoes, you are a walking, talking blood meal, okay? The female mosquito, it has a needle-like mouth, and it can penetrate the skin and go directly into your blood capillaries. So when the mosquito actually lands on you, it injects its saliva into you, okay? And in its saliva, it has an anticoagulant, which actually thins your blood, so it's easier to draw the blood. And that saliva is what causes that itch that we all know so well. It irritates the skin, and that itch, well, it's horrible. We've all been there. And some mosquitoes actually inject you with a local anesthetic. So anesthetics we use to numb, yeah? So when you go to the dentist, they inject you with an anesthetic and you can't feel anything. Very similar type of thing. They inject you with that, you can't feel anything, okay? And then they fly away, happy as Larry, full of blood, your blood. And then a few hours later, you then get the itch and you feel it all. I know, it's terrible. And here's the worst bit. These mosquitoes can pick up diseases from other humans, other animals, and transmit them directly to you, which makes them so deadly, such as transmitting things like Zika virus, malaria, yellow fever, but we'll touch up on all of them a little later. But now let's move on to the most important bit, which I imagine is the reason you're watching this video, because you've been bit by a mosquito and it's driving you crazy itching it. So let's look at those treatments. Okay, so some of the most common symptoms you might experience after a mosquito bite. Firstly, itchiness, probably the worst thing. Next, you might get red, raised skin. There might be inflammation, there might be swelling of the area. And sometimes there might actually be a bit of liquid weeping from the actual site where you've been bit. So now let's move on to the treatment tips. So tip number one, for instant relief, one of the best things that I always find to advise patients to do is ice cubes. So get some ice, wrap it in a tea towel or something, don't put it directly on the skin, and hold it there for about 30 to 60 seconds, or maybe even a few minutes, it's completely fine. Hold it there, it's gonna help reduce the swelling, it's gonna help numb the area and give some quite instant relief. Now the reason I'm saying it can be a bit difficult to do is finding ice cubes might be a little tricky. So another option would be to get some frozen vegetables or something out of the freezer, wrap it in a tea towel, do the exact same thing. And if you still can't do that, if you don't have a freezer or anything like that, open the cold water tap, run the area under the cold water tap for a few minutes to again help that area cool down. But what you don't want to do is have a hot shower or a hot bath. That's going to make things a lot worse. Tip number two. Antihistamines. These can be very useful at helping to reduce that itchiness. So I always usually recommend an antihistamine tablet. I find that they work a lot better than antihistamine creams, which generally speaking I find quite useless. But antihistamine tablets, for skin allergies in particular, I find cetirizine to be very good for it. Obviously this means that you're probably gonna have to go buy it. If you have it, great, okay? But if you don't, you can go and buy it from pharmacy. Always speak to your pharmacist first though before you take any medicines, and always read the information leaflet that comes with it to make sure that you are safe and suitable to take it. And that is the most important thing that you should always remember. Moving on to tip number three, steroid creams. Again, these can be very helpful at helping to reduce that itchiness. But remember, you only need to use a tiny amount. So a useful steroid cream, for example, is hydrocortisone cream. You can buy this over the counter from any pharmacy again. But remember to use a pea-sized amount. You only need to use a tiny amount because they're very strong. So when I say pea-sized amount, well, a fingertip unit, that's what we call it. I did do a video on how to use a steroid cream, which I'll link up here actually, because you might find it helpful. But when you use one fingertip unit, it should cover two palms in area. So that's exactly how thinly you should be using it. Please remember though, do not use a steroid cream on your face. okay? It's not licensed to be used on your face if you're buying it over the counter. You will need to speak to a healthcare professional if you're gonna want to use it on your face. And always again, read the information leaflet, speak to your pharmacist first again, always to make sure that you're safe and suitable to use it. Once again, that is the most important thing. Tip number four, painkillers. These can be really helpful with soreness and the swelling. Now, common painkillers that you can use include paracetamol or ibuprofen. They're both very good. You can use them together or you can use them separately. It makes no difference. But once again, I feel like I'm saying this all the time now, please read the information leaflet that you're safe and suitable to take it, and always speak to your pharmacist first just to make sure that you are safe to actually take that medicine. Once again, I'm gonna say it 100 times in this video, that is the most important thing because you need to be safe. Your health is the most important thing. Now, tip number five is all about trying to prevent an infection. Now, it's really important, and I know it's a lot easier than said, that you stop itching. Please refrain from it because underneath your nails are dirty, it's full of germs. The skin is probably full of germs already. And when you're itching it, you're opening up that skin, our natural barrier from germs, those germs are gonna get in, and eventually it could lead to an infection. And that's the last thing you want. No one wants a skin infection, it's terrible. Then you need to take antibiotics and it's gonna cause you all this grief just from a mosquito bite. So please, the first thing you need to do is once you've been bit, get some soap, some water, wash the area, and refrain from itching. Now we're all human, and I'm sure some of you will end up scratching those bites. And if you do, it might form a clear sort of fluid layer on it. That's quite normal for this to happen. It might even ooze as well. That's just your plasma that's oozing out. But eventually that will dry and form a scab. Now, it's probably important to remember, if that does happen to you, it's always good to keep that area clean, maybe with an antiseptic cream, and also keep it covered, because now you've actually opened that skin, so it's susceptible to getting infected. So if you've got a bandage, if you've got a plaster, place it on top of it. So that's what you need to do, but here's a bonus tip, because Abraham the pharmacist has always got your back. Okay, so here's what you need to do. After your scar has healed, well, not healed, but after it's starting to heal, you need to start moisturizing the skin. That is gonna help prevent it from leaving a scar because nobody wants a scar. Also, it might be worth using an SPF cream as well. That's just gonna help prevent pigmentation of the skin. Another bonus tip for you there. Now, there's also a few things that you should be aware of when to speak to your healthcare professional. So for example, when to know that your skin is infected and when to get help. So all of these I'm gonna leave in the description below and I would highly recommend that you read it. But one of the most important things that I need to discuss with you right now is if after you've returned back from your holiday or trip or wherever, and within those 12 months, you experience flu-like symptoms. So these include a fever, aches and pains everywhere, flu-like symptoms basically, you need to speak to your healthcare professional straight away because these can be signs of yellow fever or malaria. So it's super important that you're aware of it, and I'm gonna leave loads more information in the description below too, so please do read up about it. And remember, as I mentioned earlier, these mosquitoes can carry various different diseases such as Japanese encephalitis, dengue fever, Zika virus, and loads more. So it's really important that if you ever do have any kind of symptoms and you've been traveling abroad recently or within that year, you mention it to your healthcare professional because this is really going to help them. Okay, so we now know all about how to treat a mosquito bite. We know the science behind them and how they all work and the diseases that they spread. We know all about the red flags and what to do. But now we need to look at prevention so you can prevent yourself from getting bit in the first place, because I'm pretty sure 90% of the people watching this video will be watching it with an active bite, but there might be 10% who are being proactive, who are like, you know what, I'm gonna go traveling and I'm gonna learn how to prevent getting bit in the first place. And if you're not part of that 10%, if you're part of the 90% that's being bit, well, you need to learn this for next time. So watch it all, learn the tips, let's move on to them. Okay, so tip number one, if you're an adult, use 50% DEET spray. DEET spray is what we call it, and it contains what we call diethyl toluamide. Nobody calls it that, by the way, just call it DEET. Everyone calls it that, everyone knows it by that name, and I've had to do this part a few times because I can't pronounce it. So it's a really good repellent at repelling those mosquitoes. It's very safe to use. I wouldn't recommend using it under clothes. There's no point in doing that. So just use it for wherever the skin is exposed. Now, just like sunscreen, DEET also needs reapplying. So always read the information leaflet that comes with it for how often you should do that. Also, if you're someone who is allergic or sensitive to DEET, there are other repellent sprays available as well, which I will list in the description below. Now here's another bonus tip, because as you know, Abraham the pharmacist loves to give you those bonus tips. Please remember that if you're going to be applying DEET, it's going to reduce the sun protection that you get from your sunscreen. So please make sure that you're applying a minimum of SPF 30 or SPF 50 preferably, to help prevent you from getting sunburn. Now please also remember, first apply your sunscreen and then apply the DEET. Apply the DEET above the sunscreen, don't do it the opposite way around. Now you can get DEET from any community pharmacy, but always speak to your pharmacist first so they can go through the different products with you, speak about the different repellents that are available, because there might be something there that works better for you and better for where you're going to. That's why it's always important to speak to your healthcare professional or pharmacist so they can give you advice, and as well, make sure that you're safe and suitable to use that product. Moving on to tip number two, remember, those pesky mosquitoes can bite you at any time in the day. So with your clothing, remember the three L's. The first L, wear long sleeve clothing. Wear light clothing, so light colored, and also loose clothing. All of these are gonna help prevent you from getting bit in the first place. Because remember that if a mosquito can't land on you or get close to your skin, but you can't get bit. Tip number three, mosquitoes. They love strong smells like perfumes. And if you have loads of products that are scented, they love it and they're attracted to it. And then they're gonna come towards you and bite you. So to avoid it, to avoid them from coming towards you, you need to stop wearing the perfumes and the bath soaps and all the scented stuff. Try and get unscented things just to prevent them from being attracted to you in the first place. Moving on to tip number four, use a net over your bed, and also close those windows when you're sleeping. And if you can, turn on the air conditioning or the ceiling fan. That's gonna get some air circulating, probably on a low setting. And that air circulating is gonna stop and prevent those mosquitoes from being able to fly and get on you as well. Now with regards to the netting, firstly, make sure that it's not directly on your skin, because the mosquito can still bite you through the holes in the netting. I know, it's terrible, right? But you've got to make sure it's not touching your skin. Secondly, give it a quick little look before you go to bed, just to make sure there's no holes that have appeared in the netting. And lastly, when you set up the netting, tuck it underneath your bed. That way, it's gonna give you the best protection. Tip number five, location, location, location. Look, you need to stay away from stagnant water, such as puddles, ponds, marshes, things like that, because that is where they nest. That's where the mosquitoes nest. And then you're gonna be close to them. And then that walking, breathing blood meal that you are is gonna be close to them, and you're gonna get a bit more. So you need to stay away from them sort of areas. So remember, location, location, location. Okay guys, that's it. I really hope you found this information helpful. Lakshmi, I hope you found this information helpful. I hope anyone watching this video has found it helpful. You are now a mosquito bite pro. You know what to do. You know how to prevent them from biting you in the first place. You know what to do if you've been bit. You know all about the red flags. You know all about where they breed and everything. You're a mosquito bite pro. So spread the word, tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell your colleagues, tell someone random on the street, tell someone on holiday who's been bit by loads of mosquitoes. You now know what to do, and I really hope that you find this information helpful. But if you guys have any of your own tips, please leave a comment below too, because I would love to read it too. In case I didn't mention this in the video, I get bit by mosquitoes all the time. I'm one of these type of guys that always say, oh, I think they're attracted to me more than everyone. I imagine I'd release some kind of pheromone or scent that they love. But I've been able to implement a lot of these tactics and techniques that I've told you in today's video, and that's really massively helped. So please let us know how you get on, and leave any of your own tips below as well, because I'd love to read them. So it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's episode of responding to your comments. If I didn't get back to your comment, I'm really sorry. We get so many comments these days, so it's really hard to fit them all into one episode. The best advice I can give all of you is just leave another comment. Keep commenting, keep commenting, and eventually I will get back to you in a future episode. That's the end of this week's video. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.